Now, the next topic, I request Professor Rajagopalan Vasudevan, please come and share the lot of good ideas, disruptive innovation and plastic man, right? So welcome you, sir.
Hari Om. I'm extremely happy to be here. It's a privilege to come all the way, but still, as I was telling my colleagues, when I said to my students that I'm going to IIM, students felt as if they feel that they are going. It's one of the aim for those students to come and join here. So they felt so much happy, and so I too feel extremely happy to be here. And so many disruptive thinking are going on here. The first two lectures is totally disruptive for me. Ravichandran simply kept the audience in a great mood. I don't know whether I'm able to do it that. So that way he is disruptive. And Shrambi, we used to see films in TV, we used to see serials. Whenever there is an advertisement, we used to go away. Because that is a time for us to do something else. So when here, really about 45 minutes, he has made us to see all the advertisements. And he has so much of meaning for that. We don't know much about all those things. I used to refer here and there some of the advertisement also in my lecture, but when I really attended his lecture, it was really interesting how much things are involved in that few seconds. But still, we give so much of, rather so little respect to that, because so many things. Anyhow, I'm happy to be here again to share my thought. So I would like to, first of all, thank God for inviting me here. Parasparam bhavayanti shreha paramavastha. We must like to thank who are all responsible for us to stand here. So I thank God, and I thank my guru, who is a guru for me, both spiritual guru as well as guru for my scientific work. He gave me many, many suggestions for all the development which you are going to see now, both scientific as well as spiritual guru. I must thank him for his blessings. And above all, I must thank my two students who are with me from 2001. And because of their work only, I am standing here. I didn't do anything. They have done everything. So I must thank them also. And above all, my college, Tyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai. It's the only college in South India which never gets any capitation fee. Even for management seat, they don't get any money. They get the only fees as prescribed by the government, and real a college which works for the education. I am proud to say that I belong to that college. And more than that, I retired in 2003. Still they keep me in the job. That is also very important. I must thank the college. And above all, I used to teach to my students Bhagavad Gita every day from since 1976 till today. At 1:30, they will call me, "Sir, are you ready?" So sincerity in the work, the faith in God, takes you beyond limitation. If you work, wherever you are, whatever you are, however you are, you can definitely achieve something great. Only thing, what is needed at it? The input is only sincerity. That only has brought me all these laurels. In 2002, I had a great opportunity of spending my time with our late President Abdul Kalam, who visited my college thrice and in a span of 3 months and gave a rather laid the foundation for all the work which I have done. Once he heard about my work, he said, "Vasudevan, it's a good work. This is going to be the very important work." He said in 2002, today it is reached as he said. That is a visionary. That he is the visionary, and that's the vision he had. And 2015, I was awarded Tech Icon Award by the Prime Minister for the best technology, innovative technology for the whole of India. That the vision has been purified by our Prime Minister. And I told him I had a small chance to talk to him at the time. So this technology is very simple and cheap and very good. I said, I know about it, I want to implement it. And that has happened actually. He has released the government notification itself to lay the road. And Times of India has given incredible innovations and amazing Indian like that. And my innovation has been considered one of the five important innovations made out of an Indian. But actually, I used to introduce myself in a simple term. A waste becomes useful because of another waste. The first waste is myself. And I have become so much useful because of another waste called plastic. Now the plastic has been made into very useful material. I have been invited by you people and I am standing here. Last week I was awarded Uday Singh Award by the King of Mewar. And my work has been given an ISC coding also, that is the highest recognition in India for the road making. And I have a patent in 2006. And I was offered $300 million by states to purchase my patent to them. I said, I'm not giving to them, I'm giving to my country freely, and I'm maintaining till today. And that is the communication released by Modi for laying the plastic road. Coming to our topic, how come some confusion here? It is wealth from waste or waste from wealth? Disruptive aspect I would like to think here. Where from the waste has come today? It is only our process of making wealth. We try to develop more and more of industries. We try to develop so many things. Ultimately result in more and more of accumulation of waste. Is it wealth resulted in waste? And today we are talking about waste to for wealth. So it's a cyclic process probably. But anyhow, one thing is very important is, so I'm going to be a bit serious. You had two beautiful lectures, very light, but probably I don't think this is the time for me to give a serious lecture, but still I wish to pass on the information, my experience also, because this is a great audience who will transform it into society in the right way. So the changing attitude is very important. Most important is own your ownership. Anything which you do, whether it is advertisement or manufacturing, you must have ownership also. How far it is going to reach common man? How far it's going to be useful to the common man? How far it's going to be useful for the society, for the country, for the nature? Everything should be noted. Simply you can't say push everything to the market. And then let us, one beautiful slogan, go green. I say even that is wrong. You should not have go green, you must have a come green. You know there is one beautiful rhyme which has been taught to our children, rain, rain, go away, come again another day. This is long, long ago from British region, it comes even today, we never forget the rhyme. We don't want rain today, we want rain more and more actually. We don't have, in Tamil Nadu, we have a lot of problem, we have no rain. But we say, rain, rain, go away, no, come, very important. So come green, we want to have a come green. The whole atmosphere should be turned into green. We are only converting concrete forest, we don't have a green forest. Very, very important. Therefore, I have a very interesting aspect with respect to this. And the nature provides you everything. What is you need, not for the greed. And there are 84 lakhs living beings in the world. Only one is a human being. All other are following their own method, no disruptive. The only disruptive mechanism here is the human being. He only changes the atmosphere. He only creates all the problems. Unless he is supposed to be the ambassador of God. The Gita beautifully says, you are sent to this world to help others. You have been sent to help others. But what we do is only disrupt and create more and more a problem to the basic living. Environment has been highly polluted. Global warming increased like anything. Why? Nothing. So it is only man-made, nothing else. So nothing is a waste and everything is a resource according to the nature. You want to understand the potential. Therefore, managemental technique, I always call it managemental technique. Managemental technique is nothing but managemental technique. As man ages, managemental technique is more important because mind is more corrupt nowadays. So management is very, very important. Self-management is more important. That's why I say one-on-one. Self-management, then only you can come to the world in the right way. And he also put yesterday, today, tomorrow. I am also placing the same thing, yesterday, today, tomorrow. My yesterday is something different. Just go around 1,000 years back, people are very, very happy, live simple living, not much of facilities available. They don't have a cell and other things, but still they were living happily. Their culture was beautiful. The constructions were very good. We had 2,700 types of system in PWD for water management in Tamil Nadu 2,700 years ago. So that was the culture. People were very happy. No pollution, no environmental pollution like that. But today, we have all the materials necessary. All you have comfort and all more materials, but all the ultimate results in environmental pollution only. If this continues, and see, I have a difference of 1,000 years. Yesterday, 1,000. Today, another 50 years, India will be a dump for waste materials only. Wherever you see, only waste you can see. Even now, every corner you see, it is going to be the waste dump only. We must take something serious about it. Think about it seriously. I just give some more idea about that only. Yesterday, science was available. Today also science is available. Yesterday science made into a technology. Indian technology is much, much better than many of the countries. Our technology and our medicinal characteristic, long, long, today we are talking about nanoparticles. 2,000, 3,000 years ago, nanoparticles were manufactured by Vasudevan. That was a technique available. They manufactured the nanoparticle at the temperature of 500 degree. Today we go to 3,000, 4,000 degree more to prepare that. They know the technique. We don't adopt that technique. We only borrow technique from others. But still they were happy. It was eco-friendly. But today, what we have got, starting from cosmetics, I only go, immediately when I read this, I read like all the advertisement he has made comes to my mind. Cosmetics, drugs, fertilizer, fuel, biodiesel, paper, whatever listed, all those things come to this market now. You need to add why they have come. That's a big history, but I don't want to touch it. But anyhow, you know all these things are available. How this has helped us? This only helped us to create more and more. I don't say any much of comfort, increase your lifespan, nothing like that. You have more pharmaceutical shop, and actually we have more pharmacy shop nowadays. And doctors and pharmacy only available, nothing more. So all those things are available. Probably you may have some beauty parlor, but still you have more problems only. All those things creating problem. So what happens? Why it is so? What is the philosophy? Industry produces, marketed, and people are advertising, people helps to market it beautifully, then forget it. Do they think about it, what they have produced, what they have supplied, how it has gone, where it has gone, how it is going to help, or how it is going to affect? Nobody bothers about that. Industry's philosophy is manufacturing, marketing, forgetting it. And domestic people consume it, throw it, forget it. For example, since 2004, whoever comes to my room, I just give 2 chocolates. Everybody asks, why? This is a birthday for you? No, we haven't come, I'm just giving a chocolate. I just observe what he does. He'll take the chocolate, cut the paper, I have two dustbins on both sides. He never uses this. Keep it on my table and go. This is the habit. This is the habit. Use it, throw it. Forget it. Never bothers about it. Our government collects the waste, dump it someplace, forget it. What is the state? If this is the case, what will happen? I just give two examples only I have taken. Toothpaste, why I have taken toothpaste? Everybody uses toothpaste. Do you know why and what toothpaste, what for you are using? Do you know? Is it because of the advertisement? Somebody will come to this, in the TV scene. Do you have salt in your house? I don't know. Without salt, nobody will live. But there will be an addition. Do you have salt in your house? Then somebody comes and disappears. What for a paste? Do you know what paste you are using? Do you know why you are using that paste? Do you know what it contains? Every day, 2 grams of paste is being used. And I have just made a statistical data in Madurai. 10 lakhs people using particular brand. And every day he spits that 2 grams downward. And it gets mixed with water. 2 grams means at least 50% is calcium carbonate. And 50% means 500 kilos of calcium carbonate every day is put to the ground and the water is mixed and the water becomes hard water. Every day I only make my water hard. And I don't, and then say, I don't have water, I carry all the water in bottles and so on. Never bothers about it. Why you go for such a material? You must go for a biological decomposable material. Nothing else. Go for that. Because we don't question it, we don't take it why it is so. Similarly, cooker, beautiful. Here, plastic or wooden. Because they mentioned about cooker, I was tempted to say about the cooker also. I have made a small work on this cooker also. You know how much of heat is being used by the cooker? Just 45 to 50% heat only. Just 50% is going to the lady who is cooking there. And 50% heat wasted. 50% gas wasted. So how time 50% wasted. If you could design a different cooker and a burner, we can increase efficiency by 100%, and we can save the material. Gas can be saved, the heat can be prevented. And you know, 1 kilogram of gas, if you burn 3 kilograms of carbon dioxide produced, and the maximum pollution by the atmosphere is more by the Indian gas only. Who bought this? For the past, since the old advertisement till today, the prestige cooker shape is same there. Nothing has been changed. I have made a model for that. I have made a totally changed device where I am able to improve the efficiency by 85 to 90%. Why we are not able to think about it? We only create problem. Waste has been created. In fact, I used to even say that way. Why ladies wear sarees? Probably it may be a misfit example here, but still I would like to say that. Why they wear the saree, they fold here for many a time and have insulation here because they cook and the heat will be goes along the navel and it will affect their ulcer, it will create ulcer in the stomach. To prevent that only they have an insulation, that folding the type. This is the way of thinking, the way of life. Everything has been modernized. What do you know? What for modernization? So that's why. So sorry for going away from that. But still, waste doesn't come. Waste doesn't mean something waste thrown away. Mind, when the mind becomes waste, everything waste. So thinking starts from the mind. That's why I would like to talk something more about that. So the industries, can you not think about this? What would have been the industrial thought, I would like to say? Use eco-friendly material. And if any material is supplied, you see, for example, even take the full toothpaste. You use the toothpaste, what happened to the tube? Do any of you know what happened to that tube? Where it goes? No, the pen which you use, I use only pen, ink pen. I don't use ballpoint pen. The pen, the ballpoint pen, the refill alone per year, 1 lakh ton is being thrown away. That is the amount of waste plastic is being thrown down. So if that be the case, what will find out? What is the amount? Therefore, we only create a lot of such problem. The industry, they send the material by packing in a plastic material, whether film or something else. Do they bother about getting back that? In fact, some of the leading companies are having some consultancy with me. I'm a consultant for more than 100 companies now. Waste has made me, waste given me wealth. That's all. Only the waste has given me wealth. So, but again, one of the leading companies, I told them, these are the product you are supplying. And these are the product, once used, so much of waste is there. Can you not collect the wrappers? Can you not contain the, you just reduce 1% or 2% the cost, people will come back to you, definitely. Collect it and find out a method to reuse it. Or how best you can dispose it. It is the responsibility of the industry. Nobody bothers about it. They manufacture, supply, market it, forget it only. That is, see, the leading company who met me in 2008 said, sir, your idea is beautiful. I will come with my man, our CEO and come and talk to you. He told in 2006, today is 2017, yet to come. So we need definitely method to find out this, how best the waste can, the waste is being produced, how to use it. And in domestic, very good. We use gas, I told you the problem. Water, how many advertisements are coming to waste the water? See thing, you can wash this vessel with this waste liquid. You cannot wash this vessel with another powder. Powder and liquids are flooding in the kitchen like anything. All of them nothing but chemicals. Adding to the water and mixed, and the water goes downward and water is being polluted. Our own water is being polluted by our own self. Boomerang only, it comes. So, plastic, I'm going to talk more about it. And food waste, enormous. And organic waste. So if you go to municipal solid waste, 5% only plastic, 65-70% is organic, can be converted to manure in 15 days. And then automatically that's a wonderful manure. But what you do is, you waste the organic material and you go for industrial fertilizer, and the fertilizer only 10% is used, 90% is mixed with water and ground and pollutes the atmosphere. What should you do? Because resource available, we never bothered about it. So that's how better garbage culture is important. Is it very serious? So what has happened? The municipal solid waste, you have plastic, you got organic materials, grey water. That's why I say kitchen water, 50% of kitchen water can be reused. But we are mixing so many chemicals there. You can mixing so much of chemicals and the treatment becomes difficult. Each company, they have their own competition trying to push something new. And everything creates only problem in different form. I'm not talking about the health, that is a separate topic. I don't want to talk now. Only disruption with respect to the material only I'm talking about. So they create grey water. And industrial waste, these waste which I am presently working only, I've listed here, lime, flesh. So lime, when I said lime, from Gujarat I had a company, I have a consultancy. Every day they throw 1,000 tons of lime to sea. Every day 1,000 tons they simply throw in the sea. 1,000 tons of lime, 1,000 tons of fly ash and 1,000 tons of water, wastewater. They say therefore in Gujarat there are hundreds of companies like that. See, we are one among them only. See how much of pollution you are creating. So like that, there are many things, lime, fly ash, iron oxide slag, paper pulp, plastic, e-waste, glass fiber, ceramics, distillate and rubber, all these things I have done some small work, that's why I have listed here. There are many, many such things. And domestic waste, plastic, organic waste, concrete debris, fuel gas, tiles, cosmetics, PET bottles, paper waste, etc. So what is needed? People talk about reuse, reduce, recycle. It is only an instruction. See here, it is only an instruction. Reuse, reduce and recycle. Unless you rethink, how can you do these things? You must think about how to reuse or reduce or recycle. Rethinking is very important. And here the most interesting aspect is, we are talking about invention, innovation, I am talking about innovation. I don't talk innovation, it is innovation, Indian way of innovation. Indian way is something different. I have started my work in mere kitchenware. I didn't have money. to do my work. Mere kitchenware with small amount of kitchen apparatus. Today my lab worth of 2.5 crores. Wealth from waste. Therefore, Indian way of doing this, when Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, when he saw my work, what is that you are roasting coconut, you are serving them groundnut? Is it though? No, no, it is my process. That's how the whole process, Indian way of looking at it is something different. We have to do a lot. People from Madhya Pradesh came to me, sir, we don't have a method to convert our wheat into powder. We don't have power. In 30 kilometers radius, we don't have. What is there any method to crush it? When that be the case, we need to develop innovation. And that too in an appropriate method, appropriate technology, more suitable for our purpose. In fact, in one of the invited project presentation, I was there in Delhi. I want to present my project. I went there. On the way, it was the month of January. It was a very cold condition. People were on the roadside. They were all collecting all the waste and burning it and then warming them. I saw this. And they were most of them plastic materials. And they sit around the plastic waste and being burned, and then they've been, the atmosphere is toxic. I went to the committee, before I present my project, I told them, I have one more project now. What is such project? I said, this is a project. These cannot be avoided, but they must be provided different heating instrument, a chamber, where I can use all those same waste, but it will not pollute the atmosphere, the gas will be separated, and I can very well safeguard their health. I have a decision. On my way, I have made my own mind, and I have the design. Can I supply this to you? Before me, all the top scientists of India are sitting. What they told, you know? No, no, Vasudevan. America has done, Japan has done, what is that you are going to do? See, the American missionary or Japan missionary is not there on the road. And the American missionary cost about 15 crores. And Japan is 11 crores because competition. But what about ourselves? This is innovation. This is innovation, appropriate technology. We need it. Definitely, own your ownership, you will do that. And today the environment is very conducive. Even yesterday's our Prime Minister's speech was very, very encouraging also. Swachh Bharat, clean India is very important. Therefore, industry, there were institution innovation, innovation industry, innovation society's involvement, all the things should put together to involve. And we, the institute, can definitely work for this. We can coordinate all these things. Today, I have a project from central government, and I am developing construction, I will show about that, for constructing toilet, low-cost toilet. So we can go to the government, we can use the waste material also. So the institution can definitely do that by developing appropriate technology, socially relevant, eco-friendly, and biomimicry, very important. Nature has got all the techniques, understand it. And you can develop it, newer technique, no problem. And practice before you preach. So far I was preaching. I want to do some. No, all these things are my experience only because of the practices I am doing. What I have done, I have just mentioned here. I have used plastic used for packing and domestic waste. 55% of the plastic used is for packing only. It is thermocool, foam, carry bag, multi-layer films, all these plastic materials. And e-waste, unlimited now. Every day new cell phones are coming. There are so many names they say, I don't know much about that. But every day newer one, what happened to the previous one? Who is, what is the fate of that? It contains 2,000 toxic chemicals. If you just throw it, it will spoil the land, it will spoil the water, it will find atmosphere. It contains about 1 to 2% of precious metal. People will take that one. The rest of the things simply throw away. And it's going on increasing like anything. E-waste, how to? And your TV, all those electronic gadgets, you say it is convenient, but I feel all of them are trembling like anything because they are going to dump more and more. Every day, e-waste. And the organic waste, weeds,
We have organic, India has got 30% organic waste, which has not been used because of the modern fuel technology. If those 30% has been conveniently used for method, we can save 30% of purchase of petroleum, and our economic condition much will be very much improved. Only thing, we need to design a furnace for that. Simple furnace. Why we moved from wood to gas? If you know that reason, we can very well define that one. We can do that. And then wastewater, I already mentioned about that. Fuel, biodiesel. I will add one more point here, biodiesel. It is only from seed, but it is not a particular seed. In Madurai, where I'm coming, there are 12 types of seeds available, which is not available otherwise. Those 12 seeds can be used there itself. It is a region oriented, like that every place there are some waste seeds available. And those, every seed has got oil. And when I was talking about this to one of my village friend, he said, we call it sapota. Chiku. He said, the seeds of Chiku, I got a lot of seeds. I asked him to get, he gave me, next day he gave me two kilos of the seeds. I crushed it and got this liquid that can be directly added to the petrol bunk and you can burn in the car. You need not modify it at all. It is directly useful, more better than your petrol. Available in Chiku. Who is using it at? So like that. Sorry, I'm cross my lime to meet because we are the lecturers always. Solid waste, concrete waste, scrap waste. See, when I was laying the road at Simla, the chief secretary called me, told me, sir, we have a lot of concrete waste. Because in the hillock, people will try to demolish and then keep it there itself. What to do with that? We did not find out a method. We have found out a method for that also. Scrap waste, slag, gypsum, etc. All like that, so many waste are available. We have worked on all those things. And plastic, film, cup, foam, everything, now converted into used either for road or for block making. I'll show about all those things. Roof making, corrosion prevention, and polymer modified bitumen. I will come across all those things later on. And the seeds for biodiesel and weeds, seaweeds are available. The seaweeds can be taken, and from the seaweed, I have developed a compound. Compounds are available. Sodium alginate is available. I have converted into calcium alginate, and I have used it for developing a medicine for curing diabetes wound. That compound is available in the States, cost $50 per strip, whereas my strip will cost not even 1 rupee. I want to manufacture this and give it freely to all. Though because India, Indian poor people, villages, 50% are bothers because of diabetes. So it's available, can be used. Waste, sea waste, into diabetes. So organic waste, manure, waste rubber, automobiles going on increasing day by day. What about the tire? They are throwing the tire away. What is how to dispose the tire? Even in 2007, Netherlands came to me. They said 60,000 tons of tire they are burning every year to dispose that. How much of pollution? A tire has got 18 components, starting from sulfur, creates all the problem. So we must find out a method to use that also. You should not create any problem, those wastes like that. I will show some of those things also. And waste rubber, slag, ceramics, construction material, water, drinking water. These are the work which I have done already and recorded and published also. And here, there is no question of particular department, inter-department. Nowadays, this is a concept itself. In 1998, when I was interviewed for a professor post, my management asked me, how many papers you have published? I said, only three. Why? My PhD thesis, three only. Then, I am a consultant for 100 companies. What do you mean by that? Every company, they have a problem one day or other. I solve the problem. Even the every problem solved means it's a paper. Cannot consider it's a paper. My management kept quiet for some time. I thought definitely they are not going to give the post for me. I'm not, therefore I thought more about that. By doing that consulting, how much I've helped the company, I told them. Next day, I got the appointment order. Not only that, the management gave a notification to the college, here for the everybody should do consultancy. So because there was always inter-department cooperation is not there. Every department is an island. Now inter-department we can do. Now, I don't know whether I am a chemistry professor or a civil engineering professor. I have addressed the chief engineers of India at Delhi. Chemistry professor. Chemistry lecturer, I won't say even professor. The lecturer addressing the chief engineers of India, because of the waste becomes wealth. So, small steps towards my process. Use of waste plastic. I told you already, it is polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, carry bags, multi-layer films, thermocool and foams, teacups. When I say teacups, I would like to add one more point. The teacup which you use here, I don't know, we have not used teacup here. It's a paper cup. It is not a paper cup. The inner layer is false plastic. And the very thin film is there. If the hot coffee or tea is there, the film will also, along with the tea, will go. That creates a lot of problems. Such a thin film can create all the problems. Better you take plastic cup, take the tea or coffee, give it to me, I will lay the road. So, use plastic, the paper cup don't get, these are marketing people. They deceive like a paper cup. What is the, where is the, if you have a coffee in a paper, it will, how can it be there? Paper is their wetting property. But we all take it, a paper cup, so I don't want to bother about it. So that's how, from the toothpaste, paper cup, it's all the same. So, use some waste plastic, you have a better road now. I laid a road, first road in 2002. Even today, it is not having any pothole. 2017. Since then, we have led more than, in Tamil Nadu, 20,000 kilometers. It's 11 states are implementing now this technology. 1 lakh kilometers have been led. We have seen roads, I normally used to give 7 years as a warranty. Now, more than 10 years as it is maintaining. Not even a crack has been developed. No pothole, no crack. With any amount of load, the roads are working very well. No more details now. And it's I'm going to give the details in only now. And we save bitumen. For 10% bitumen, minimum 10% bitumen is saved. And that is going to reduce the cost of the road laying, and our resource is going to be coming for another 50 years. And then costless and solid waste can be, now once the plastic has got the value. Now the plastic per kilo in Chennai, it costs about 30 rupees per kg. So the value has been increased like anything now. And people are having counters to collect the plastic now. And once plastic removed, this organic material can be converted to manure, and organic vegetables now very famous now, you know. Food to get organic vegetables is very costly. You have plenty of organic manure is available. We don't use it at all. Now it can be used very well. And job for self-help group. Why for self-help group? Yesterday, MHRD, I got a message, you know. 60% of the BE are unemployed. What will happen if that is the, it continues? And he says several lakhs man hours are not used. Why? All looking about only one aspect, IT, IT, IT. Why you think about IT? There are so many opportunities available. Everybody can have a job of his own. He can make money. Definitely, waste gives wealth today. In other sense, I can say these fellows can find wonderful job here because I'm unable to meet the demand which I have got now. So much is the job is available. See here, the waste, wherever you go, you see the plastic waste. And I just given what are the waste, plastic, LDP, polythene and biscuit covers. Biscuit covers, chocolate covers, panpora covers. These are multi-layers. The inner core is aluminium, outer core polyester, in between polyethylene and polypropylene. You cannot recycle it. It can be only reused. What for? Only for road. And it gives a best road also. Comparing to polyethylene, polypropylene, the multi-layer gives wonderful. I will show some details also later on. And the photo which you see here, that road was laid in 2004. Immediately they load another road. Before that, the highways also laid the road. After 6 months, they took a photo. The highways has given way. You see the highways road. The other road, even today, 2004 was laid. You can come and see that road even today. The road is the same pattern, beautiful. So that is the specialty of the plastic road. And Here, no problem. The only slide is scientific title, detail is all this polyethylene, polypropylene, they soften. When I heat it, they soften. And the softened condition, they are a beautiful adhesive. I'm able to use the adhesive character for binding the bitumen and the stone. That's all the whole work. Very simple work. Very, very simple work that has only taken me to this level. Simplest ever possible. 30 seconds extra for the whole work. So, but the plastic has got the binding quality. So that is the most interesting part. And by heat only, for road making, the maximum temperature requires 170 only. When you heat any plastic 170, nothing will happen, no gas will be allowed. Only we go beyond 250 degree, some gas may, pollution may take place. Therefore, in the construction of road, nothing serious about, no toxic gas, only useful aspect taking place. And the thermal stability up to 250, decomposition beyond 250, toxic nature, polyethylene, polypropylene, polystyrene, no toxic effect at all. And softening temperature 120 to 140. And see, that aggregate stone is taken, add waste plastic and mix it and make a block. This made up of stone and plastic alone, nothing else. This can withstand 300 tons load. Even if I apply 1500 tons load, it only extends, it never breaks. There is no material in the whole of the world, a material, structural material like this, because everything breaks. This is never, it withstands the load means, they say, people now say, I started making this for paper block. People say this can withstand a bullet, this can withstand earthquake. We want this type of material for construction of places like water as well as where there is earthquake. This is another, I'll come to this later on. That this only to show waste plastic, this only stone and waste plastic only. You had a beautiful block which can very good load also, and it's got a lot of use. And once you coat plastic, now what happens? Pothole. What is, you know, what is pothole? You take a stone, add bitumen, take the stone, heat to 170 degree, add the bitumen which is 160 degree, mix these two, load the laying. Laying the road, that's all. But what happens whenever there is a water stagnation or rain, the water penetrates between the stone and the bitumen and peels off. So once the stone peels off, pothole form. But what I have done now is, take the stone, add the plastic, coat it first, laminate the stone. Now add bitumen. The plastic acts as a beautiful binder. And no water entry, no pothole formation. And now the strength is increased. Therefore, normally, as per the civil engineering regulation, it should withstand 1,000 kg. But my road withstand 2,500 kg. Strong, doubled, strength-wise increase. And today, you don't have four-wheeler truck. You have eight-wheeler truck, 12-wheeler truck. The load is increased. This is the only road which can fit into the current atmosphere also. So development with respect to the need also takes place. And therefore, this development, this is a simple test. If you put in water, peeling off should not be there for 24 hours. Even, I cannot say 24 years, now it's already 15 or 16 years, nothing has happened, the road was working very well. And this is a scientific data, I don't want to say much. And I have proved that this is binding, this is a table which says, if I wash with the proper solvent, it retains, the plastic retains the bitumen very well. Because I don't know how many are we scientifically interested in that, I don't know. But anyhow, I just go. So this is how, from 1,500, I have increased to 2,450. Then double the strength. Strength was increased, binding was increased, no pothole formation. What else you need for a better road? And cost wise less. And see here, this wanted to show various plastics, of which the best for me here is the multilayer. Multilayer gives the best adhesion, therefore it can be used, because that is the one. Kurkuri, biscuit, see how much of waste available, no? If you could come and see my lab, I have a heap of such materials available. It's available everywhere. This is now most important. If all the plastic, now I will come to the data later on, what India has got only 10% of what I need. India has got 41 lakhs kilometers of road. To lay 41 kilometers road, 41 lakhs, we need 1 lakh tons of plastic. We do not have first. India has got just 10% of what they need. 90% we have to import waste plastic from other countries. So this is scientific data, how would the binding take place. Now this is the road. Aggregate, stone is taken. It is heated 170 degree. Waste plastic, shredded into small pieces. If you want, you can see later on. These are the waste plastics. I just go, because I came from flight, I cannot carry more weight. Therefore, I made a smaller packet like that. This is the multi-layer films. This is a beautiful sample from the paper mills. Paper mills, they have all the paper. Nowadays, your notebook are laminated. So the top layer is, again, polyethylene. That's a waste. They don't know what to do. Now that has been collected, and this is a beautiful material because very thin polyethylene that can be used. And every factory, not less than 10 tons they have got every day. Wonderful resource available for making wealth, definitely waste from wealth. So this is another material. This is our PET bottle, which is going to be added in the industry block. I will tell you later on about that. So later on, many this, Neo, please watch. So hot bitumen, and then I add the bitumen. Oh, the whole road is constructed this much only, technology only this much. Take the aggregate, heat it, add plastic, 30 seconds only plastic takes to get a coating. That's 30 seconds. Add bitumen, mix it, lay the road. I'm just add only 30 minutes, 30 seconds extra for the whole road laying. And this is the process, plastic waste, shedding machines available, very cheap only. Government is also giving loan for purchasing these shedding machines, and the heating, stone heating, and this everything is available in it also. You can also take it, don't bother about it. If you want, I can give you all those things. Nothing, everything is available. So the stone is heated to 170 degree, and the plastic is, quantitative addition of plastic is added, and then bitumen is added, and the road is laid, finished. Only just 30 seconds, you go, the whole process is over. And see, no need for segregation. But all plastic can be used, even separated. All types of plastic can be used. No cleaning required. I wanted dry. I don't want wet. You should not wait. So just put, we have wonderful sun in India. Dry it and give the dry material, that is sufficient. And shedding alone needed, no toxic evolution, no burning or no landfilling, nothing necessary. Above all, 1 kilo, if you use plastic, 3 kilos of carbon dioxide prevent, otherwise they are burned. So India has already laid 1 lakh kilometers, means 3 lakhs tons of carbon dioxide prevented entry to the atmosphere by this plastic road. And see the road, the silent features, multi-layer films can be used, no new machinery existing. I even adopt whatever machine they got, I try to find out. Because when I say this is not useful, they will drop the idea. But they will always find out. In fact, the CEO of Madhya Pradesh, rural development, she came to Madurai and she met me, and then she told me, I came here to find out what are all the problems in the process, and I want to negate the process, but I could find only positive aspects. I could negate. I am going there to help the people to lay the plastic road, and they laid and then called me for addressing them. I went there like that. In situ process. There you can use whatever available there itself. You can, no granulation powder, eco-friendly, only stone is modified. And then above all, the recent development, scrap. What you do is, the existing load, you know, they want to relay. You scrap the top layer, black top layer. Now 50% keep it, 50% fresh material coated. Just mix these two, lay it. We save 50% cost. Normally 20,000. 1 kilometer, 10 lakhs, now it is only 6 lakhs, 50% only. And not only that, the road height is not improved, the same height is maintained. Raw material, quarrying material need not, 50% saved. So quarry material saved, cost is saved, road height is maintained, beautiful road you get. So scrap can be used, value addition to waste plastic also. And the roads are strong, no pothole, with an heavy loads, decreased bitumen consumption. So for 1 kilometer road, simply, single lane 1 kilometer road, we need 10 tons of bitumen normal road. Now what I do is, first take the stone, add 1 ton of plastic and coat, and then add only 9 ton. 10% of the bitumen I am saving it, that means 1 ton of bitumen is 50,000 rupees. Plastic 1 ton is 5,000 rupees to 10,000 rupees only. You save, and the road, for maintenance, every year India spends more than 3,000 crores. But today, this road, for 10 years, no maintenance at all. So that much amount of money saved because of maintenance also, so no effect, and definitely improves much better, cost wise less. And I only requested people, there are 41 lakhs kilometers in India, of which 24 lakhs kilometers are rural roads only. And rural roads are rarely laid. Let us lay all the waste collected from the highways, can be converted, instead of dumping in one corner, take it and convert it into rural road. And you save the money and the road much better. And economic and road will have much, much better, long life, and you have wonderful transportation technique also. We can very well use it. So it has been adopted by almost all, now it is 11 states are using this technology. National Rural Road Development, they have, throughout India they are adopting technology. On private sector also, many companies, they are taking this technology also. And we have done the performance studies also, and we have proved that our work, our roads are much, much better than the conventional road. We have done, and scientifically it has been approved by Central Control of Pollution Board, Central Pollution Control Board. Normally I used to say Central Pollution Board, Central Pollution Board. Somehow the control is missing there. So, Central Control, Central Pollution Control Board, they have approved the technology, and I got the patent also. And see, the pollution control, CBA has given the notification, performance study has been given. I was invited to states. I didn't go states. They invited me to present my work. When I went there, I was a bit hesitant because those people are very great. We may not be knowing much. Therefore, I was very, but once I presented, I could understand they don't know anything. And because we teachers, you know, we know the students' face. So next session, I became the chairman. And they took me throughout America. And they said during the winter, the whole road is completely spoiled because of the snow. They want to have a road which can withstand 0 degree. And we have developed that till now. I have developed a new mix which can, I can lay the road at 0 degree. Now we have laid at Kodaikanal, and for the past 5 years, the road is making well. This clue was given by my guru only. He only say, he asked me before my invitation was staged, have you done any work for the low temperature? He asked me. I don't know much about that. What is that he is saying about it? Guru says, I must say, yes, sir. Similarly, but the moment I came to my place, I was invited, and now I have developed a new method for that also. And our Chief Minister Tamil Nadu, she was the first lady, 2004, the first lady who met me. And I just explained 5 minutes about this. Wonderful Vasudevan, I will implement it. 1,000 kilometers road will be laid immediately. That year she started. From that, it is going on very well. And this is for the scrap. I have already mentioned about these details. This is about the block, plastone. Now it is called as the one, I just brought one small sample for that only. This is what I call plastone, as I called synthetic granite. This is a substitute for granite. It is cheaper than granite, stronger than granite. And nowadays the tabletops are used by epoxy variety only. Epoxy is 6 times costlier than granite. This is cheaper than granite, but better than epoxy. So many companies are now, seven foreign countries are interested. Last week, I had visitors from Indonesia. This council general, with all the team was there. He was very much interested. See, I'm a simple man studying, sitting on one corner of India, doing some small work. But what is an importance for the work? It is only for the waste becomes wealth. That is what we can say that word. Therefore, this is now wonderful material. And this can be used, see here. This is immediately mass media came and gave a lot of importance. Here I can use not only stone, I can use ceramics, I can use lime waste, I can use concrete debris, I can use, and I can use PET bottle, crushed in like this, in one foot by one foot, I have 16 bottles inside. So disposal of 6 PET bottles is there. Disposal of concrete waste is there, ceramic waste, tiles waste, all those things can be, and you can have wonderful product. And see here, what are the materials you are using it? Limestone, lime powder, fly ash, e-waste. Now we have developed e-waste, a solution for the e-waste also. Probably I'm crossing my limit. No, I'm just being money. I hope I will finish it. No problem. This is the various types of blocks, that is plaster we have developed. I have just to see, I have given here. And use of this plaster, see here, pathway block, paver block, water canal lining, compound wall, portable walls, actually land floors, bricks, and then rail sleepers, portable sleepers. In fact, one day my wife asked me, why is that when we are crossing by scooter, there was a speed breaker made out of the rubber. When we were just moving, there was so much of bump, and then she felt the bump. Hey, what's it you are doing so many things, you are not able to find out a method for this substitute for speed breaker. Then I went there, when she has told me, she must take it very seriously, no? Otherwise, next day you will not get a food. No. So I immediately went and developed a portable speed breaker now we have made. And whenever minister comes, you can remove it. And we can fix it, no problem, because the binder we have developed, and we can fix it and then use it. So that is a portable sleepmaker. My ultimate aim is railway sleeper should be made out of that. If that is done, India has got 60,000 kilometers of highways. If on both sides one meter width of pathway block is laid using this material, I need 10 lakh tons of plastic. I need 10 lakh tons of plastic for only pathway block for the 60,000 kilometers highways only. India has got only 3 lakh tons only. I need 30 lakh tons. So we have to import 90% of the plastic from other countries, or use more plastic given to me, please. I always say plastic is poor man's friend, you know. The standard of living a poor man is improved because of plastic. Today he's having plastic chair, plastic bucket, plastic, all materials plastic because of his life is convenient. So we can't say ban plastic. Use plastic, give it to me. That is a way of disposing. So disposing is not at all a problem. So only rethink and reuse it. Disruptive mechanism is available. Definitely we can convert it into material like that. And e-waste also joins here. And this is the new construction which we are doing now. This is made up of this. A block is made and walls have been constructed. This is a portable, 10 minutes you can construct the room. They want to have a low cost toilet, and we have given a project from the central government. And even this process now, I was directly called by the PA of Prime Minister. To get a project like that, I have not learned. Just an invitation from the PA, Prime Minister, had a discussion, told about we want it before 2019. They want it. Please do it. How much money? So that is how the fast level of interaction is going on also. And this is another material we'll develop, roofing. Normally, see, all this is from wasteful. That's why I want to share this idea. Please give me 2 minutes more. See, it is only wood about your cardboard. Cardboard only, they are corrugated cardboard dip in bitumen, they use it as a roofing material. Now given a coating of plastic, and normal life is only 10 months. This comes for 3 years. Poor man's life is improved, and that is, this is another material which has been developed. From the flux, I heard this has been printed in paper, is it so? This, the
band. Why you
say that? Oh, then it's all right. This is normal. But the normal they use in PVC or polyester only. Let us here, this is a waste after the conflagration. What will happen to that?
Even before the conflagration.
So what I have done is, I am using it and then developed a coating material over that using the bitumen and the plastic. And this is a material which kept on the surface, the top surface of the house, where leaching of water, rain is in Kodaikanal, Ooty, it is very, very important. So this has been developed. And it's again a waste material, so it's got a lot of demand. And bitumen now I have made, this is e-waste converted into modified bitumen. It is another new product we have developed, modified bitumen. And then this is the logo, the cold process which we have developed. And we have also, my colleague is also converting plastic into petrol. It is also going in my laboratory. It is also a well-developed process. We have got the petrol also. And your topic is waste from wealth from waste. I started my laboratory in 2001. Sadar, before starting this work, I had only very small container, a cooking container. Today my lab is worth about more than 2.5 crores. having all the special instruments which are necessary for testing plastic or for the road. My lab is fully equipped with the complete testing of the road as well as testing of plastic, all because of the waste plastic. Waste has given me wealth to that extent. Not only that, now I'm a consultant of many, many companies on waste manufacturing, and many companies like, see here, I got listed some of the companies. I don't want to read it because it takes more time. So many companies are coming now. I'm not able to do the work because I don't have manpower. The problem today is I'm working in engineering college. There are 4,000 students are studying and nearly about 700 students are civil engineering, but nobody bothers about this work. All of them worried only about this computer, and all of them goes to only type of job, IT job, and nobody interested in type of work. And therefore the problem is there is opportunity. Very, very few people are coming here, and I thank the people who have all helped me in all this respect. I wanted to thank, and I just quote Bhagavad Gita: "Sagaya gya prajaa sushta paro vacha prajapati anena prashvidyam yesho ishta kamadu." The world, he says, Gita says, world is kamadenu. Whatever you want, it ready to give. But why you give something wrong? Don't give, it is ready to give all what is needed. And it is for the betterment of you. Please, Devan Bhavede Devo Bhavayantaka, Parasparam Bhavayantaka, Shreha Param. Be friendly to the nature. Nature will give you all. That's all the slogan. Work is, world is, follow the ethics of life. Very important. And Brahma created plastic. Shiva had to show me the decomposition of plastic. The meantime, Vishnu has showed me, hey, use it for road laying. And we are doing it. And my student's name is given here. And this is my address, 24/7. I'm available for any discussion, for anything in this direction. Thank you very much.